Hello and assalamu alaikum to all the people watching Evolve Talks. I am Aman Khan and we are back with yet another session of Evolve Talks. And today we have with us a very interesting guest and who's personally my favorite, Mr. Shadab Ali Khan. He is the group advisor of DS Group of Companies and has served Pakistan Army for more than 30 years and is currently working with different projects with the government, with different NGOs, Hunar Foundation, Fala Foundation, Friends of Mayo, and is an amazing person who I think if you enter DS Group and you ask any person that who's your favorite, the first name that will pop up will be Sir Shadab. So before any delay, I'll have him online.
Hello, viewers. Good evening, everybody.
Hello, sir. How are you?
Absolutely fine. I'm absolutely so happy to be here answering
We're
your concise questions. I know it's very not easy
It's
to
an
face
honor to
you.
have you. It's an honor to have you. I hope we're going to have very fun, so much fun talking. And thank you so much for giving us a precious time.
No, it's pleasure is mine, and I'm all available to you now this evening. Please go ahead.
Fine. So the first of all, हम लोग थोड़ी सी कैजुअल डिस्कशन कर लेते हैं. Like it's different world for all of us right now. This lockdown situation. So tell us कि आपका लॉकडाउन कैसा गुजरा. आई एम श्योर यू आर द ओनली पर्सन आउट ऑफ अस जिनका सबसे ज्यादा प्रोडक्टिव होगा.
I think you are right on that dot because I have utilized this last 1.5 month or 2 months very well for my multifarious activities. As you know, I am very deeply involved in different NGOs. An NGO of health sector, we are renovating Mayo, we are providing care to the corona patients. Then we have a Fala Foundation, which is for the special kids, and also running
Amazing.
Hunar Foundation. So I kept myself completely busy and I could dedicate more.
Very nice. So before we move on, आपने खुद जिक्र भी कर दिया ऑफ द एनजीओज एंड स्टफ. सो आई लाइक यू टू टेल अस अबाउट फला फाउंडेशन.
Yeah, Fala Foundation is a very interesting concept. Normally, what people come up with is the special school for the special children. But Fala is quite different. It's known as the inclusive, right? In inclusive, they have 50% able and 50% special. And this is an
Amazing.
inclusive training, and it's a very, very interesting phenomena. So when you happen to come and watch those kids merge together, dovetail with each other's activities, it's amazing life, it's an amazing world. And I was really taken aback pleasantly 2 years back when I joined Fala Foundation as to how able boy can cope up with a disabled boy. How can a disabled or special child not be complexed by somebody sitting beside him who's absolutely fit physically and mentally? So that merging of the two different phenomena is worth seeing. So that's the specialty about Fala. That's why I was attracted. That's why I joined it. And it's not an ordinary special school. It's a very, very it's a theme which is now world is catching up with. It's not common
That
phenomenon in Pakistan, but
that's
outside
definitely an
people are.
amazing concept.
Yeah, it's the same concept. Yeah, that the teachers have done has to do half the job. The other half is done by the comrade, the colleague, the next bench boy who's able. And the one thing which really surprised me when we took them out on different trips like a zoo or Great Iqbal Park and picnics, it's very difficult to see from a distance as to who is able and who has got a handicap. None. They were giggling, they were laughing, they were shouting, they were dancing on a tune, and they were snatching their chips and enjoying it. So it was an amazing world I've never seen in my life. So that's why I'm out of my three NGOs. This is the one which is closer to my heart, and I give maximum time to them.
It's
So
amazing.
you can
It's
ask anything about Fala Foundation, and I'll tell you how amazing Madam Faria is running this foundation for last 11 years.
डेफिनेटली इट्स वेरी गुड टू हेयर कि अभी भी ऐसी फाउंडेशंस हैं जो कि बच्चों में इस तरह बिल्कुल डिफरेंस क्रिएट किए बगैर देयर इज अ हेल्दी एनवायरनमेंट गोइंग ऑन फॉर द स्पेशल किड्स. देन कमिंग टू द सेकंड वन, व्हाट अबाउट फ्रेंड्स ऑफ मायो हॉस्पिटल. सिंस
फ्रेंड्स
आजकल
ऑफ मे
ऑल दिस
हॉस्पिटल,
कोरोना
या
सिचुएशन इज गोइंग ऑन, सो हॉस्पिटल्स आर द मेजर, आई थिंक द हीरोज आर वर्किंग देयर.
या basically the concept of FOMH, Friends of Mayo Hospital. It's a group of highly placed men and women, like the head of Fatma Group, and like Naya Itada, like the top doctors of Shaukat Khanam. They're all with us, and we, together we work for the betterment of Mayo Health. What they do is that they get donations, and the donations are naturally massive in crores, and we pick a ward, and then we refurbish it, renovate it to the best of our ability, and we bring it the same as it used to be in the British days. So we try to use the old material in their tiling work, in their roof, in their window, polishing the same door. So far, FOMH, your Friends of Mayo, has renovated 7 wards. And it's over 100 million, spending over 100 million of the donations. And another concept which we have picked up after the Prime Minister gave a mandate to the people that you must have a shelter homes. So we have recently completed a shelter home within the Mayo. So it's not for the patient, it's for the attendants. So whenever one goes to the Mayo, you find that the attendants are sitting on ground with a sheet spread over footpath, having their food. It was highly, you can say, not a dignified way. So what we provide them a very dignified way.
Many hospitals.
Yeah, most of the hospitals. So we provided them a shelter with all the fans and washrooms and tiled and all that. And it's like very airy. It's not closed, so you don't have to air condition it. It's a very breezy and windy. And so their attendants can go and rest there. They have benches. And outside the shelter, we have paved the entire area with plants. So we have shading trees. So they sit under the shade. So much so that we have dedicated an area where the small kids can go and play the swing or seesaw or whatever it is. No?
So it's amazing.
So it has been, so apart from renovating the wards and giving comfort to the patients, even to the doctors. I was amazed when I went there with my group and initially, and we found that the ICU, even ICU was so rotten with their broken chairs and sofas and cats chasing the mice. So it was very, very discouraging sort of a scenario. But now you'll find them all tiled, washroom made, proper furniture there. So we had made an arrangement with the Secretary of Health or the Minister of Health that whatever the donation is given in terms of mud and mortar and tiles, you give us a matching grant to Mayo. So what they do is they match it with their new equipment, with the new air conditioning system. So that way it's a synergy. We both do it. We as an NGO create an environment, a very neat and clean environment, and then they bring in the Mayo people. The equipment, X-ray equipment. The 7th and the 8th ward now with us is, very soon we are going to start, is the oncology. It's a cancer ward. And the other one on the radar is a burn center for the children. Because we saw small kids, few months old, all burnt out, their mother running around with them in the lab. And there's no place to really have them treated. So we are developing a burn unit for the peds, for the kids, children. And also going to work start on the oncology. So that's the story of FOMH. It's a very, very encouraging and to see all those men and women at the helm of the affairs working so dedicated.
No doubt. That's the second FOMH is doing a great job, and so is the Fala Foundation, and I'm sure that Hunar Foundation ka bhi yahi hal hoga. So tell us about Hunar Foundation.
Hunar Foundation is actually basing. What we realize is that there is an organization since ages known as TCF, the Citizen Foundation. What the Citizen Foundation does is almost every month or 2 months they open a school up to the metric for the needy and poor boys and girls. And so far they have opened in Pakistan 1,400 schools, 1,400. Yeah. And then one day when we were sitting in, 1,400. And now increasing every month, every 3 months they are increasing. And one day we realized that after teaching boys and girls, the poor people gets just up to the metric and leaving them was not enough. So we thought of creating an organization which should give them the skill. So until as a Pakistan kids are skilled, they really cannot achieve much progress economically. So what we did is that we created a under TCF umbrella, THF.
THF.
Yeah, the THF. So the, we have now in Lahore, Bedia, opened up the first in Punjab. Then we opened one in Multan and one in Kharia. And these three in Punjab, and we are more in Sindh, we are more in Karachi, but we are looking after, I'm associated with the Punjab, these three one now. And they have six to seven disciplines, electrical, mechanical, plumbing. And we also had a very interesting for the girls, even boys, the industrial stitching. Because the big industrialists, yeah, they came to us, they said, if you can make them skilled in the stitching industrial, though, they will be easy for us to hire them. Otherwise, absolutely a raw boy or girl going onto the stitching line, they would do a lot of damage to the whole system and, you know, breaking their threads and all. So we teach them the basics of industrial stitching. We are doing also air conditioning, and you will be very happy to know that the boys, after 6 months diploma, they get a certificate from AFTA, and the boys and girls of high merit, they get a certificate from City and Guild UK. So it's a UK certificate. The team comes from the UK and they take their test practically. And once they give them the certificate, and the whole world is open to them to go out and work as a skilled person. So Hunar Foundation is equally important for me. So this is how I spend my time after my retirement from the army and for my civil life now. And
that's amazing. You, and that, talking about the Hunar Foundation, I've myself seen the students of Hunar Foundation working for DS Global as well. They're definitely learning very new things. So it's definitely a very good initiative. So coming to the part of our main topic that we are discussing today, that is, I think, very important, that is discipline in the businesses. And who knows a discipline more than a person who has served army for 30 years? So being
be precise,
a person who's...
Aman, to be precise, I joined the army in June 66 and I retired in 2000, so 34 years.
34 years, amazing.
Yeah.
So it's more than 30 years.
Yeah. And then I was taken also as while in uniform as a Secretary Communication Works in Government of Punjab. So I also had the honor to serve as Secretary Government of Punjab for 5 years, longest serving secretary ever in uniform. And after that, you as you have already mentioned in my write-up, that I then went as an advisor to the WAPDA authority.
WAPDA authority.
I made sure that our major projects were completed in time, like Neelam Jhelum, Tarbila, additional power, and the Mangla Basin, and Kachi Canal in Sindh. So I had the distinction as an engineer to work for such a prestigious organization, which has given me a great pleasure, really. And I, when I look backward, so it's now almost 54 years I've served the nation. And still ticking, still want to serve more.
Still want to serve more.
Yeah, with 54 years of service, so you can imagine that still I feel myself, and mainly I think because Hunar has a lot to do, the Fala has a lot to do, the health sector has a lot to do, because that gives you incentive. Huh? But now let's go back to this, your topic, which you say is that how discipline can really help.
Before coming to the topic, I have a question right now, and it's that you just mentioned the 54 years of service. So mostly people don't serve this much and are not this much active throughout their life. So what do you think was the key to this? What drove you to be this much active, mashallah?
Discipline,
definitely discipline. So coming to the topic this
life.
Way.
Yeah, that's the topic. So I was so
that's
excited. So discipline is basically the basic key to success in every field. Now, it is a key to success for an individual, for an organization, for an office, for a country, for a nation. Without discipline, I think everything collapses. It's the key to success. So when you say how important it is for a business to grow, I say this question should be, it is so vital. There's no ambiguity. There is no way to really convince people. It is vital. It's like a lifeline. I call it discipline is the lifeline. It makes you remain focused. It makes you work as a team, right? It makes you work for your growth, to attain your targets. Discipline is one thing I found that whenever I was confronted with obstacles, with impediments in my life, even frustration, the only thing which really put me through. was different activities. I was out of the project, overcome the obstacles. And so discipline is, I must say, it's not for business, it's for everyone. The child everyone, at home, yeah. We as individual, everything. So discipline, I think, should be in a, running in our veins like a blood. That should be the bloodline, the lifeline is discipline. So on discipline, right. You can ask me anything.
Yeah, so you just mentioned, and I think many people agree on this, that discipline is the key to every success of life. But how hard is it to attain that discipline in life? Not most people have it. So how you can attain that discipline in life?
Yeah, it's a good question. For that, the key word is willpower. If I have the willpower, I can discipline myself. So the first step is you have the willpower. Now, how do you inculcate the willpower?
Mm-hmm.
I would say if you have faith, of course, in your creator, in Allah. So the faith, I suppose, I must say, is the faith. Through faith, you create Allah. That willpower gives you your mental ability or capability to start discipline yourself. So in discipline, mm-hmm. Aman, first of all, we have to discipline ourselves, our thoughts, our acts. Entire, the whole structure, physical structure, my mental structure, the most disciplined.
I'm really sorry to interrupt you, sir. But आपका पिछले आंसर में सारी आवाज कट हो गई थी. If you can repeat that again.
जी, I say first of all, how do you create discipline? You create discipline by having a willpower in yourself. The willpower comes how? It comes through your faith. Faith in your ability, faith in your Allah. These two things you carry forward and you start making your strong willpower. If I have got a strong willpower, nobody can deter me from my disciplined path.
Mm-hmm.
And then I start discipline. And the discipline starts from here, from my mind. I discipline my thoughts. Then I focus myself on my work. So discipline in my work, discipline with my team. So everything revolves around the discipline. Basically, what is discipline? It's putting things in the right perspective. Prioritizing them as they come across to you. What is the priority, right? And that discipline exactly. Then carries you through. So it's a very interesting topic, and I suppose that this is one thing which we should be brought before the public the maximum. Everybody,
for sure.
Yeah, discipline, willpower, faith. These are the 3-4 things. If you pick up these things, I think you have achieved your life complete. People at times ask as to why have been created. I mean, I go into the deeper now, into the philosophical sort of a realm of the things. Why are we created? Why has this been world created? Huh? What was the aim of the creator to have our people who are so rowdy and so ill-disciplined and so self-centered at times? Why to have this world? It is because Allah had a hope. Had a hope in his creation that one day they are going to have faith in them, faith on me. They will be the most disciplined lot on this earth. They will help each other. So I would say that if you go to the deeper meaning, the philosophical meaning, the marfat ki baat agar karti ho aap na, to marfat mein, to this is what was desired of us when we were created. And
exactly.
You know very well that in Quran, the angels did object to Almighty, said, why are you trying to create a creation which is so ill-disciplined, you know, and they're going to fight each other. He said, no, I have a hope. I depend on them and they will do well. So wherever we are disciplined, we have seen the nations. You know how the countries are rated all over the world. The most disciplined nation is a success story. Why Japan could control? Because of discipline, the corona, right?
Exactly.
Can you believe it that in Taiwan, not a single shop or activity was stopped. No school was closed. Continuously, the boys, the kids were going for the school and shops were open. Even then, they could overcome the problem through the discipline. Discipline of distancing, of protecting themselves. And the other disciplines, like not shaking hands and all that. So the success story is like South Korea, Taiwan, the other countries. So you can talk of, days and days, and the topic of discipline won't finish.
So exactly. Now you can ask. So you talk that it's about having the faith, it's all in the mind, it's all about willpower. But do you think it, being a disciplined person furthermore also revolves around how you were brought up? Because if you bring up a child with a proper in a proper disciplined environment, he's definitely grow up to be a disciplined person. So what are your thoughts on that?
I should have sided with your concept. Yes, it starts from your childhood. But let me disclose my secret to the public, whosoever's listening. I was the most ill-disciplined child.
Okay.
My mom tried to discipline me, but I was not to be disciplined so easily. And I was the most rowdy and most carefree and most naughty boy ever seen anywhere in our family. And so one day what happened is that while I was doing through all these disciplined gimmicks, and I said that now go and join the army and fight for my country, and and so my colleagues goodbye, my college friends, they were whispering in each other's ear that Shada will not survive the army, he'll be court-martialed and thrown out. A so ill-disciplined boy going to the army will be thrown out very soon. So we'll see him back in our group. And so when I was thrown into the army, my God, I must salute my military academy who trained me, who really tempered me as if they temper and steel in the burning fire. So I was in the cauldron, burning fire, came out disciplined to the maximum. So it's necessary that right from the childhood you have to have a disciplined kid to become a disciplined grown-up man. It's not necessary. It's ideal, of course, ideal. But I see my own condition. The more disciplined, went into a most disciplined organization, the Pakistan Army, and survived, not thrown out, right? And adopted their discipline onto me through my willpower and my faith, and mostly my desire to serve in khaki. Since I was so fond of wearing khaki and serving for the nation, and 71 war, I fought as if I've been given, you know, a lifetime chance to go and, you know, fight and be there and kill and be killed, right? So all this thrill was there. So the most ill-disciplined kid could be disciplined once put into a very, very, you know, defined and disciplined organization.
So as we're talking about your thought of joining army here, so there's a very interesting story about you joining army that we all at DSG know. So for all the people watching, I'd like you to tell that how you joined army, because as far as I know, you didn't have much plan of joining army and it was a sudden plan. So I'd like you to share that with the people watching.
It was like any youth with a lot of warm blood in his veins. I also have a warm blood, and I was throughout being my scouting camping and jamborees and going to different jamborees in Iran and all that. So basically, I was already into this sort of a venture and you can say adventurous life. Basically, I'm adventurous nature, very, very. So when I was completed my college, I got admission in UK as an engineer, civil engineer. And suddenly the 65 war came. And there were songs of Noor Jahan being played, right? And my blood was boiling as to how am I sitting at home and trying to go to UK for engineering. I should have been given, actually sneaked out with one of my friends and filled the form for army. And one day when the letter came from the army that you are called for the ISSB, my mother was shocked to know that instead of going to UK, I'm going to the front for war. So it's very interesting. So basically, it was my desire and wish to serve my country and lead a very adventurous life. I wanted to lead a very adventurous life. So when I was given a choice, what part of the army you would like to join? I said, give me the one which is the most life-threatening. So the core of engineers is the most life threatening because we deal with explosives, we deal with mines, we put mines before the moving tanks to blow them up. So the most life threatening, most thrilling is the core of engineers. So this is how I landed here.
Amazing. It's definitely a very interesting story for a person who I myself was going to do engineering. So someone who was going for engineering and then shifted that to army. So that's a drastic change, but an interesting one. So coming back to the topic, you about the discipline. So we were talking about having discipline in life, how it's important. And I hope the main topic was how discipline is important in your business. So how do you think a discipline, having a discipline in your business helps it to grow more?
Yeah, when I, one of the example is like your DS group. I visit and I find that people working in a very well-defined sort of their own whatever have been the parameters and whatever have been given to them, the marketing, the finance, everybody, they're so well disciplined in their own fields and the departments. And there's so much of cohesion. The more disciplined they are, the more interaction is smooth, right? And there is no haphazardness there. Everybody knows what their objectives are, how they have to fulfill it. So discipline is not like a marching of a soldier. Discipline means that you are undergoing and undertaking your defined role. So everybody's having his own role and they are so smoothly dovetailing with each other. If marketing is to do with the sale and sale with the, you know, actual execution and the finance and everybody. So it's a very, very disciplined team you find there at DS Global, I found. And similarly, I've seen many other. So it's a success story, the discipline. So discipline means everybody knows his job, their assignment, they're focused, they're good at teamwork, they help each other. And at no stage, they feel themselves frustrated. If there's an impediment, there's an obstacle, they overcome it through their willpower and through the disciplined acts. So it's very, very important, Aman, to have a discipline in any organization for a success.
I totally agree. So there's a question here that, yes, let's suppose that it's a fact that discipline is very important for any organization, for any business, but we're talking about the main businesses sector here. So how can someone generate the feeling of discipline in their organization? Okay, not every employee is different. Every employee has different qualities. So how can you have discipline in your organization?
I would say that I had a hands-on experience. When I was put in as a safety communication Punjab, it was the most disorganized and ill-disciplined department with 26,000 people. So I had to, in a way, look after 26,000 people. And the people like chief minister were really fed up that it's a more ill-disciplined, ill-organized, even corrupt, you can say. So what to do it? So I thought of it when I was sent there from a very, very disciplined organization of army and asked to take over as secretary and be accountable, right? As a principal accounting officer, be answerable and be answerable to each and every person. And if anything ill-disciplined happened in my organization, I am to be blamed because the buck stops at the top, right? So I gave it a thought. I said, the day one when I took over as secretary, it was the very memorable day for me. A man in uniform suddenly, you know, catapulted into an organization, so ill-disciplined, the largest organization in Punjab, the largest organization. And so I thought what to do it. And there came a flash in my mind. I said, I'm coming from a disciplined organization. Let me show them what a discipline really means. So let me lead them by example. Mm-hmm. So that day I decided, before sitting on the chair of secretary, I was holding the back of the chair. Before I sit, I thought, let me make myself clear, what am I going to do? What will be my first step to impress people and to let and to lead them? Otherwise, they are going to really throw me out by not cooperating. They have a way. Civilians have a way. If they overlook your orders, they avoid you and they really try to disappoint you. They can spoil my project. They can do anything, right? So I said, let me lead them by example. So I sat on the chair and I said, from now onward, I will be the first man who will be the most disciplined. He used to come at 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock. So I used to be dot at the time, 8 o'clock, and leave the last, come the first. And then everything is to be done, was to be done through a defined procedure and system. And can you imagine, Aman, that I was so successful that within, after 1 year only, I stayed there five. Uh-huh. After 1 year, I was able to achieve ISO certification for the best management. It was the first ISO given to any government organization in the country. It's given to government labs, government hospitals, government other like libraries, but never to a department which is so messed up. So after 1 year, we got I was called in Governor House, some Modi's came and they gave my department the certification, IO certification for the most well-managed department.
Amazing, wonderful.
When I was a disciplined, everybody followed me. So when you say how to create a discipline, I am the witness to it. I'm a hands-on experience, disciplining 26,000 people behind me. They're not army, Aman. In army, it's very easy. The moment I'm sent to a new station, I just have to say, do this, and they say, yes, sir. There was no yes, sir. There was no, they argue, and they really confronted me on many things because it was a technical department. I had to tell them I'm right by profession, by my expertise, by my own self. They weren't just listening to my orders. They were not army men. They were not soldiers.
So, it's achievable.
Even the worst of the organization can be disciplined if you have a good leader, somebody to
guide. Very good.
Because Aman, maine dekha, I found that every human being, how bad, how poor, how ill-disciplined he is, he aspires to have somebody who should lead him.
Exactly. That's human nature.
They do not need a boss. I could have bossed them. I had a stick in my hand as a brigadier. I could have bossed them. Really, I can tell you. But I put aside my stick. I said, let's not boss them. Let's join them and lead them. So I was a leader, not a boss for them. They could just walk in into my office and get their problems resolved. So that's the key. Satisfied?
So that's the thing, that to have that, to achieve anything, you don't have to be the bossy person. You be an example for the employees.
Be firm. Example for them. You can't be really chummy with them. So you have to be firm with them. What you say, you should mean it. But don't have to be bossy. They understand your body language. They understand what you want. They can read our faces better than anybody else. Our body language can be read by a subordinate. Even office boy can read my body language, what I really mean. So you have to discipline everything. So I had to discipline my thoughts. I had to discipline my timings, discipline every act of mine. I first made myself the most disciplined person possible. And then my department followed me. They followed blindly, eyes closed.
Blind.
That's why they say in army, if you order a sepoy to jump into the fire, he won't ask why. He has to jump and then face the consequences. So that type of discipline can be achieved just by the personal example and dedicate and discipline yourself.
So you talked about disciplining a government organization, which let's accept that is a hard thing to do in Pakistan. So talking about the government organizations and right now all this corona situation and this lockdown situation going on. So recently, aapne ye bhi dekha ke even the lockdown is lifted up now. So do you think that our current government and all the authorities are disciplined enough to lead the, they are disciplined enough and they're leading the nation discipline wise?
Their intentions are correct. Their intentions are right. As far as the discipline is concerned, they are trying their best to appear a very disciplined lot of the leaders, right? The only problem is that they have not a very clear mandate. They are still not on one page. Some of our provinces, they want the lockdown should be lifted. Some says, no, it should be still. Even in America, you find Trump is saying something else and the governor saying something else. So the problem is that this is a very typical sort of a problem, which is not that easy to confront with, because you are dealing with human lives. One wrong decision, and today the spike in the country was 1,000 fell victim to the corona. तो इसलिए इस खाली डिसिप्लिन की बात नहीं है, लक भी है, यू नो गॉड्स हेल्प भी चाहिए और लोगों को बहुत ज्यादा अवेयरनेस चाहिए. अभी भी वो हो रहा है, पीपल कमिंग फ्रॉम अब्रॉड बैक होम, दे स्टिल गो इनटू द पार्टीज, दे मीट देयर फैमिलीज, सो द होल फैमिली ऑफ 30-40 पीपल आर गेटिंग इन्फेक्टेड इवन नाउ टुडे. तो ये डिसिप्लिन तो डिसिप्लिन करना पड़ेगा. एवरी सिटीजन हैज टू बी सेल्फ डिसिप्लिन. इसमें लीडर को मैं इतना ज्यादा ब्लेम नहीं कर रहा हूँ. Leader has just there to guide you, you know, to guide you to lay down the parameters. But I think we have.
That's the thing that leaders ko bhi itna nahi hona chahiye. Lekin right now, for as far this situation is concerned, I also agree ke logon ka disciplined hona zyada zaruri hai. Kyunki jab humne lockdown bhi dekha, there was not a single day ke maine wo 100% lockdown dekha ho. People were still out, and okay, we get the point that the daily wages have to be the out. But some people were out even when unnecessary. So coming to this point, do you think ke abhi jo ye lockdown situation lift up hui hai, so ye ek sahi faisla hai government ki taraf se?
I think under the conditions, yes, it is. Sirf ye hai ke support kar dein jo poor log hain, people are dying of hunger. You see, so everybody has to play the part, the government. For example, we in Fala Foundation, the kids were not coming, but their parents were at home and they were all poor labor. So whatever money we had collected, we sent the monthly rations to the kids home for their parents. So ये हमें करना पड़ेगा. So discipline तो करना है, lockdown तो करना बड़ा ज़रूरी है. But then it has to be mitigated. The suffering has to be mitigated through help. Imran Khan is doing, the government is doing. A lot of money has been spent. अब imagine करो कि big organization, they can now draw money from state bank as a loan to pay their employees. इससे ज्यादा और हेल्प क्या? सो द कंपनीज आर क्लेमिंग द मनी फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट टू बी पेड लेटर ऑन, डेफर्ड पेमेंट, एंड पीपल आर गेटिंग पेड थ्रू द स्टेट बैंक. सो गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग इट्स बेस्ट, इसमें कोई शक नहीं है. पीपल शुड बी मोर डिसिप्लिन.
चलो लेट्स होप दैट थिंग्स कूल डाउन स्लोली. सो देयर इज वन थिंग दैट आई वांट टू आस्क, दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट डिसिप्लिन, ऑल डिसिप्लिन दिस दैट, सो वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट बिजनेस ग्रोथ हियर. So apart from discipline, if I ask you that what are the three things which you think that can help a business excel if the best, so what are the three things you would say?
First of all is that the team should be motivated. Mm-hmm. Right, this is very, very important. And when you say motivated, means you have to have a leader on the job. If you have the right leader and the team is motivated, then second is that it should be focused. Mm-hmm. I'm motivated, but I do not know which direction I have to move. So I have to have a vision. And very interesting thing I may tell you, that a company to be a success, when you got the best of the leaders, the best of the bosses, the best who could head company like Chrysler or like IBM, their success story says that when they came, they did not give them any vision, that this is the vision and this is your target. No. First of all, they made the team. So the first thing for a success is the right team. So if I have the right team with me and I give them the right task and the vision, the second step, right? And then third is that we move towards that target or the achievement through a disciplined manner. So first of all, the right team, the right people.
The right team.
If somebody is not ready to board the bus, they should be left out. The first thing is the right selection of the team member. If the team members are right, the leader on the top, the vision, the focus, and the discipline. These three, four things are the keys for the success of any business. Then you have no problem at all.
Okay, very well. So, sir, this is a live session, so we get a lot of questions. So today we were getting a lot of questions beforehand. So we have shorted out few questions for you, and one question was very common in them. So I'll flash it on the screen as well. And it's how to join army after graduation. That was the most asked question.
Yeah, actually, Abhiska system has become so easy. In my days, I had to search out where is the recruitment center, where is the form. No. Now you have to click www.army. The moment the whole thing flashed before you, which is the latest course for which they are calling you, what type of courses, everything is flashed on the screen of your laptop, of your computer. You just have to do www.army, join army or something like that. Baki wo khud pick kar lega. As the rest, it will pick herself. So the moment you do it, so they'll tell you which course is running, which course is now forthcoming. They are going to give you a call notice for so-and-so course. Every type, you want a medical, you want technical, like engineering, you want a fighting arm, and similarly for Navy, similarly for Air Force. So it's the most easy, everything is digitized now. It's available on the net now. You don't have to go anywhere. You download the performer, the form, fill it up, you send it, and they'll call you. So they call you in different stages. The initial screening, right? Initial medical, and keep on progressing. So you don't have to really, you'll be guided. It is a very user-friendly system now. So
very nice. So we have another comment, and it's from Shazia Bukhari. Shazia is saying that people nowadays get motivated only by money. It's not enough anymore motivation by words, and that's what we don't have in order. So do you agree on this?
No, money is never the motivation, right? It could be a partly incentive. It could be a comfort. It could be a mental comfort that I've got enough money to survive. But as far as the motivation is concerned, I can tell you that motivation is by good leadership, sincere efforts. And you can say you bring them close to you as a team and listen to them. I can again give you example of my communication works department, where my poor people like Naib Qasid and the senior like chief engineers, none of them got a penny extra for me while I was motivating them. Not a penny in their pay package. I could only do was make them mentally comfortable. They got their promotion in time. They got their postings on merit. They were listened whenever they're in a problem, right? So the motivation was because the way they were handled.
Yes.
They got motivated because they were given due regard as a human. Unki izzat e nafs ko agar aap na touch kare na, the most motivated person is whom you give that due regard to his the person as a human. He is literally motivated and he can achieve anything for you, not the money.
For sure. So I hope, Raza, you got your answer. And we have another question, and it is that any references needed to join army? Nothing is easy in Pakistan. Reference is no one tool people utilize. So I, what do you say on that?
Not so far, as far as my experience concerned, with 34 years in army, and my one son in army as a colonel, for whom I didn't even tell anybody that my son is joining. He just went through the competition. Nobody told anyone that he's son of a brigadier, and he came up on his own merit. So without merit, army mein to 99% cases hai. It's very, very rare that somebody is left out and somebody says, ki yaar, itna bura nahi hai, take him up, koi baat nahi hai. He will make up for his, if he could run 1 mile in that time frame, he will pick up the stamina. Such like weaknesses may be overcome by somebody's call or somebody's reference. But not classically, any sifarish required. Nothing.
Yes, I personally agree on that, because I was recently rejected from Air Force with just because I had eyesight weak of -2 and -2, and I was rejected just because, though I had very good marks in my initial test, but I was rejected just because of -2 eyesight weak. So I agree that there's no reference in army. So I hope, Shazia, you got your answer, and we'll be moving towards the end of the session. But towards the end of session, I have a very interesting question for you. And it is that...
Who has posed that question? Oh, my
that
God.
Nazifa posed this question.
You're taking my life out.
So we would like you to tell us about this photo.
It's a lovely photo. I don't know how you got it. It's a very, very personal photo from my album. Probably if you find on my left is not my wife, she's my life, in fact. I live for her and I would like to die for her. Even with 45 years of being together, I thought I spent just 45 minutes with her. So what a lovely companion she was. And I really miss her after she left me a couple of years back. So in this, we were sitting in Quetta. It was a mild winter. And on close to my lab is my elder son, who is a colonel in the army. He's a doctor. He's a specialist. Uh-huh. Then he did his gastro specialist, and now he's a liver specialist, liver transplant specialist. Mm-hmm. He's the most qualified colonel in the army now, doctor, sitting on my lab. And he was asking me a question. And the, probably the question was that on my wife's left, my smaller son, who is in America, doing very fine in Microsoft, as to why he's so upset. Look at his face. Why is he so, you know, grumpy? Yeah. So the smaller one is giving a grumpy look, and the elder was asking me, why is he so grumpy? So the, so I have only two sons, and I'm lucky that today these two daughter-in-laws are, in fact, my daughters. So we, myself, my wife used to miss our daughters, but now we have two sons and two daughters. And in our house, the system is that our daughters take precedence over our sons' opinion.
So, very nice. So I think that's how it should be everywhere. Yeah, so it's rare.
Yeah, but this is how I am, because I, when I got when I brought them home as my daughter-in-law, I said, "Beta, tum ghar aa gaye ho. Now your opinion matters more than my son's opinion, and on any matter of my house or everywhere." No? So this is how we are now living. The only thing which is if my wife is missing. Otherwise, I'm very contented. I believe that God had everything, you know, set out for how the life has to be spent and at what stage who leaves and who joins us. So no regrets, Aman, no regrets.
Definitely. That's a wonderful picture. And did you find out why the little one was so grumpy later?
He was fed up. He says, too much, I'm waiting and the picture is not being taken. I'm fed up. He was very, very naughty. He was more naughty than I am. And today his son, younger son has beaten him now. My grandson has beaten even my son, younger son. So he was so naughty. He said, I'm going to play. Why have you forced me to sit on this sofa? Let me go and ride my bicycle. So he was pulled by my wife, placed him on the sofa and told him, please sit down for just 5 seconds. It's, we are being pictured. So this is how he was very grumpy. He wanted to run away to play his game, you know, the younger one. So it's thank you very much for reviving my good memories by this picture. I was really amazed from where you got it, really. So
yes, you my know where I got it, and that's Nazifa. Nazifa has her ways. So yes,
Nazifa, you
thank
too.
You. Concluding the topic, it's thank you so much, and I really had the fun. And I must say that so far that has been my favorite session till now, and I really hope to have many more with you in future. Thank you so much.
Pleasure is mine. Thank you very much. Thank you, viewers. I'm so happy. Thank you, Aman.
Right. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.
And as I'm disciplined, I must be sleeping by before 10. So let me go and hit the bed. This is one of my disciplines that I, before 10, my lights had to be off. So all my grandkids have slept, and I'm putting my lights off now. Okay. Good night. Thank you.
Okay. Good night. Allah Hafiz. Thank you.
Allah Hafiz.
So I really hope that you all had a good time and enjoyed this conversation. And by having a conclusion from this conversation, we all will try to attain discipline in our life. And discipline is, as said, not about being the articulate army person, a very strict orders. It's more about knowing what you want to do and knowing when you have to do it. So signing out and stay safe.